this section, we're going to be factoring what we call a difference, subtraction, of squares. So it's first necessary to know what a perfect square is. It's a number times itself, like 1 times 1, 2 times 2, 3 times 3, 4 times 4, 5 times 5. These are all perfect squares because when I take their roots, I get 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 7 times 7, 8 times 8, 9 times 9, 10 times 10, on out to infinity. Because it goes on out forever, we can't list them all. So sometimes when they get big, we're wondering, is it a perfect square? How do we check? Well, the square root of 25 is exactly 5. That's why it's a perfect square. Its root is a nice whole number. Is there some number times itself? That is 289. To do that, we check on our calculator and we take the square root of 289. And it'll give us a 17. Because it wasn't 17.4 or 16.5, because there was no decimal, it's a whole number, we know that it's a perfect square. It's 17 times 17. So perfect squares are whole numbers times themselves. We also have perfect square variables, which is any variable to an even power. X squared is x times x. Y to the fourth is y squared times y squared. X squared y to the fourth is xy squared times xy squared. So any variable to an even power is also considered a perfect square. So if we have a difference of perfect squares, something times itself, something times itself, it's really easy to factor or unfoil that because we say our firsts, a times a, our lasts, b times b. There's our a squared and our b squared. But we want to make sure when we FOIL that the outside and the inside disappear. So we need to have one positive and one negative. Let's go practice. So here we have x times x minus 5 times 5. So those are perfect squares. They are quantities times themselves. So when I unfoil, how can I get x squared? X times x. Samers is what I like to call them. How can I get 25? 5 times 5. Samers. But I need to have a positive and a negative so that when I check by FOILing, I'll get firsts, x squared. Outsides are minus 5x, inside is plus 5x, and they cancel. And then my lasts, minus 25. So when we spot these differences of numbers times themselves or variables times themselves, it's really easy to factor or unfoil because we say, well, how do I get 4x squared? Samers. How do I get 9? Samers. But I need to have outside and inside cancel. So I need a positive and a negative. And I can always check by FOILing. Firsts, 4x squared. Outsides, minus 6x. Inside, plus 6x. They cancel. And my lasts, minus 9. So when we see something times itself minus something times itself, that should trigger factoring by differences of squares.